Silicon dioxide, or silica, is a compound which possesses a remarkable variety of polyforms, where alpha quartz is the crystalline form which is commonly present in nature. Although quartz is a colorless and transparent solid, it may contain some impurities that impart color, resulting in some gemstone varieties such as amethysts, which show a beautiful violet color, rose quartz, which is pink, smoky quartz, with brown color, milky quartz, which is white, and some other important varieties. When silica is in the crystalline form, as happened in quartz, it is constituted by a three-dimensional network of tetrahedral repeating units of SiO4-4-, which are interconnected but sharing every corner oxygen atom with the adjacent tetrahedron. In the crystalline form, the tetrahedron are regularly arranged in a space, whereas when silicon is in a non-crystalline form, known as vitreous silica glass, the distribution of tetrahedron is more irregular. Silicon dioxide is the major component of rocks, soil clays and sands, with a proportion around the 95%, and after water is the most studied compound in chemistry. Many books in literature dedicate most of their content to describe its physical and chemical properties. In this video, we will only describe some of these most important features of silica, but we encourage you to read and learn more about this important combination. Silica is inert in the presence of all acids, with the exception of HF, which reacts with silica to give silicon tetrafluoride, but interestingly, it dissolves slowly in high concentrated alkali. In order to dissolve silica quickly, it's necessary to employ fused alkali or carbonates. Due to this reactivity of silica, very concentrated alkaline solutions cannot be stored in glass bottles. The reaction with hydrofluoric acid is exploited for etch design in glasses. In addition, silica is attacked by fluorine, but it remains unaltered in the presence of the rest of halogens. The reaction gives tetrafluoroxylene, which in contact with water rapidly hydrolyzes to form silicic acid and hexafluoroxylicic acid. With respect to the physical properties of silica, it should be remarked its higher melting point, which has been determined to be 1723 Celsius degree, its high hardness and strength, and its transparency to visible and ultraviolet light. These exceptional properties, in addition to its very low coefficient of expansion and its excellent chemistry durability, made this compound very useful as an optical material. For example, fused silica is employed in the fabrication of optical components such as window, lens and prism. Furthermore, due to the bareference genes of crystalline quartz, this is widely used in polarizing optics. Another important property of quartz is the piezoelectricity, that is, the ability to convert mechanical pressure into electricity or vice versa, which is very useful to make electronic oscillator employed in radios, watches, clocks or computers. Another form of silica that should be mentioned is its hydrated form, which is commonly known as silica gel, SiO2 and water. This form of silica find application in the laboratory as desiccant and also for keeping electronic devices and drugs dry. This material contains about 4% water by mass, but it is capable to absorb a large number of water molecules, with the advantage that it can be reused after heating for several hours. Furthermore, it exists another family of compounds with silicon dioxide in their composition. They are named aerogels, and they present a particular characteristics of contain a large number of pores extended throughout the structure of the silica. It is estimated that the 99% of an aerogel's block is empty, and as a result, this material presents a very low density, although they are still strong. It is also noteworthy that these materials are also very good thermal insulators and represent the slowest media in which the sun can travel. On the other hand, silicates constitutes about 95% of the rocks of the Earth crust, and the variety of silicates mineral is enormous. Generally, silicates are widely insoluble as evidences for the rain resistance of the rock during millions of years. The only exception is sodium silicate, which can be prepared by reacting solid silicon dioxide with molten sodium carbonate, as is shown in the following equation. The complicated silicate structure can be easily understood considering the simple tetrahedral SiO4 unit from which they are built, in a similar way we have already seen with silica. Each tetrahedron unit contains a silicon atom at the center and four oxygen atoms at the vertices. However, silicate chemistry is much more complex, and different types of silicates are recognized on the basis of the degree of polymerization of these tetrahedral units. The simplest class is the nesosilicates, which contain independent tetrahedral units which are not linked to other silica tetrahedron by certain oxygen atoms. This type of silicates are also known as orthosilicates or island silicates, and some examples of nesosilicates are olivine, andulocytes, or topaz. When there is a deficiency in the number of oxygen atoms, it's not possible to maintain four oxygen atoms for each silicon. It is possible to share oxygen atom between adjacent tetrahedron and retain for all silicon atoms the tetrahedral environment. Accordingly, if we combine two nesosilicates to form a double tetrahedron, we obtain what is called a sorosilicate or pyrosilicate. Sorosilicates contain then the unit Si2O76-, whose structure is shown on the screen. One typical example of mineral with this structure is thorbitite, a mineral orthosilicate of scandium. Incidentally, it is possible to convert a nesosilicate to a sorosilicate by addition of an acid, as is shown in the following equation. As we see, the net charge of the sorosilicates is -6. In order to rationalize how we have obtained the net charge for the sorosilicate, we should consider the following aspects. Its terminal oxygen atom contributes with -1 to the net charge of the SiO4 unit, whilst its shared oxygen atoms contribute with 0. For instance, the nesosilicates SiO4 4- will have 4 oxygen terminal atoms which each contribute with -1, giving the total charge of -4. In the case of sorosilicates, we have 3 unshared oxygen atoms which each contribute with -1 for each silicon, and 1 shared silicon which no contribute to the charge. That means that the charge for each silicon atom will be -3. As we have 2 silicon, the net charge will be 2 times -3, that will give us -6 as the net charge. These rules are valid also for silica and for more complicated structure with more shared tetrahedron, as we will see later. The SiO2 unit of silica has no net charge because all the oxygen atoms are shared. However, structures having 3 tetrahedron linked are quite rare, although there are some examples discovered in the literature. A most usual situation is when each tetrahedron shares 2 oxygen atoms to form cyclic silicates of different number of tetrahedron, where those with 3 or 6 units are the more common. This class of silicates are known as cyclosilicates, that with all previous consideration to the charge balance in mind, arrange of SiO4 unit which should share atom per silicon atom will be represented by the following formula and chart: SiO3-2- repeated n times. For instance, the mineral beryl, which is the major source of beryllium, which formula is shown here on the screens, contains the units SI6O18, and the net charge will be minus 12. In other cases, it's also possible that tetrahedrons are linked forming single linear chains, and therefore each tetrahedron will share two oxygen atoms, as happened in the case of cyclosilicates. This family of silicates are known as inosilicates as chains, and this structure is the basis of a group of minerals called pyroxene. Furthermore, there are another configuration for inosilicates, alternative to those of single chain, in which units can join and cross-link to form long double chain silicates with empirical formula of Si4O11-6-. These silicates are usually referred as inosilicates as bands, and this polymeric structure includes the family of amphiboles minerals, commercially known as asbestos. In addition, the cations are packed in among these chains and will determine the identity of the mineral. For instance, the mineral crocidolite, which formula appears on the screen, is commonly known as blue asbestos. Alternatively, if double chain of silicates link side by side and give sheets of empirical formula Si2O5-, we have phyllosilicates, for example, for the mineral chrysotile, a mineral of magnesium, which is known as white asbestos. Asbestos has been used for thousands of years. In example, ancient Greeks used as wicks for their lamps. However, their use declined rapidly as a result of awareness of the health risks for embedded asbestos fibers on the land surface, being the white asbestos the less harmful. Considering that asbestos is a very convenient and inexpensive fireproof element, it is still used as brake linings, engine gaskets, and even as a filter material for wine. Other important groups belong to the family of phyllosilicates are clays and micas. The last family of silicates are those characterized by tetrahedral units, where the all oxygen atoms are shared, giving a three-dimensional framework. This family is known as testosilicates, where the more representative group of minerals will be the group of quartz, and it also includes other important families as feldspar and zeolites. It's also important to consider that tetrahedron for each type of silicates described can be arranged in different ways, and this aspect will extremely affect the final structure of the mineral. A common example of this situation is found in the group of quartz, where we found that the crystal structure of polyform tridymite, cristobalite, and the one quartz represent different ways of leaking tetrahedron by all corners, and therefore, in order to change from one polyform to another, it will be necessary to break and create bonds. Obviously, minor changes in the structure can originate major changes in properties. For example, when the structure of white asbestos mentioned earlier consists in alternating layers of silicate and hydroxide ions, as appear in figure A, it's slightly changed and we have a layer of hydroxide ions between two layers of silicate ions, as is shown in figure B, we have a different formula for the compound, that is Mg3 Si2O5 two times and OH two times, and totally different material that is known as talc is formed. The new distribution in talc led to form electrically neutral layers, and therefore the material will be as slippery as graphite, what will make quite useful for ceramic, fine paper, paint, as cosmetic product, talcum powder. Other important class of materials derived from silicon dioxide with relevant properties in our society are glasses. Obviously, Here we only discuss silicate glasses that are based on silica as main component, but obviously many other materials with other composition are allocated in this category. In science, the term glass is not related with the composition of the material, but it refers to a supercooled liquid that has solidified without crystallization. This type of a material lacks of the typical long-range order of a crystal, and it has an amorphous structure, which no means a complete state of disorder, but it only has a well-defined short-range order. Silicate glasses are not crystalline materials, which are based on a three-dimensional network of silicon dioxide and are the most important type of glasses, accounting for about 95% of the total glass production. Glasses are produced by heating pure silicon dioxide above 2000 Celsius degrees and then leaving the resulting viscous liquid to cool down into molds. The resulting materials have great strength, low thermal expansion, and high transparency. For this reason, glass has been employed as material for more than 5,000 years, and the current production can be estimated about 100 million tons. This material offers the possibility to change their main properties by adding other oxide. As a result, there are three main types of glasses commonly produced. The main glasses produced today are first soda-lime glass with a proportion of 73% of silicon dioxide, 11% of lime and 13% of sodium oxide. We represent the 90%, this type of glass represents the 90% of the total production. It presents a low melting point and is commonly employed for soft drinks bottles and in building industry. The function of sodium oxide is a flux, whilst the function of calcium oxide is a stabilizer. In addition, borosilicate glass will have a proportion of 81% of silicon dioxide, 11% of boron oxide, and 5% of sodium oxide, offers as many features is resistant to crack from thermal stress when heated. These materials are widely employed in chemistry laboratories or in building industry for fire-resistant glazing. Finally, lead glasses with a composition of 60% of silicon dioxide, 24% of lead oxide, and 15% of potassium oxide. This type of glasses are used for fine glassware since good glass surfaces are very sparkling as a result of its high refractive index. Additionally, as lead is a strong absorber of radiation, lead glasses are also used over cathode ray tubes. For finish this video, we would like to comment some aspects about a type of compound of silicon with high relevance, polysilicon, commonly called as silicons. They are very extensive family of polymers which consists on chains of network of alternating silicon and oxygen atoms, where the silicon atoms can be also substituted by organic groups such as methyl group, phenyl, and so on. The structure is the structure of the simple silicon is represented in the following figure, where the number of repeating units n is very large. The most common technology for preparing organosilicons involves first the synthesis of organodichlorosilanes through a process called Muller-Rochow process, which also termed as direct synthesis, because the product is generated starting from elemental silicon. The process can be summarized as follows. First, in a fluidized bed reactor at 300 Celsius degrees are brought together gaseous chloromethane and methyl chloride and elemental silicon, which is finally ground and mixed with copper with will-add as a catalyst. The catalytic action of copper is based on the formation of silicide CO3SI, which facilitate the oxidative addiction of the methyl chloride to silicon, liberating again the copper. The reaction conduced to acylene mixture, where the main product is dimethyl dichloromethane, that can be separated by distillation from the mixture. The next step involves the hydrolysis of dichloroxylane by addition of an excess of water. The isothermic reaction gives a disulfonyl compound that readily condenses with hydrochloric acid, acting as a catalyst to form a mixture of linear and cyclic oligomers that unfortunately are too short for many applications. But these linear oligomers can be condensed again, and the cyclic oligomers can also be polymerized by reopening polymerization employing different acid or base catalysts. Polymer chain length, and therefore the final molecular weight and viscosity, are controlled by adding a chain stopper, such as hexamethyl dixoloxane, to obtain and block polydimethyl xyloxane. After removal, the remaining cyclic, under vacuum and high temperature, we obtain silicon oil consisting on a mixture of long and short polydimethyl xyloxane. It is important to remark for this process the importance to remove any residual of catalyst, because mostly of catalysts employed in the polymerization of silicons also catalyze the process of depolymerization, especially in the presence of water at elevated temperature. Therefore, longer chains are obtained when working under vacuum and by increasing the temperature in order to remove any residual water. These silicon oils are characterized by low pressure, vapor pressure and low temperature coefficient of viscosity, which are resistant to the attack of acids and bases, high electrical resistance, and also have a low surface tension. Silicon oils find unusual application as lubricants and hydraulic braking system, considering they experience a low variation in viscosity with temperature. We contrast with the dramatic change that usually happens with hydrocarbon oils. When the polymerization process of fabrication of silicons is carried out from a monomer with one or non-organic substituent, it is possible to perform additional transformation by cross-linking reaction to give silicons elastomers. In order to increase the strength of the polymer, elastomers are usually reinforced by employing fillers such as fume silica. Silicon elastomers have a remarkable low glass transition temperature, and they maintain elastomeric behavior over a wide range of temperatures, showing a good low temperature resistance and great stability at high temperature. They also have a good chemical stability, being stable to degradation, and are moderately biocompatible, which make very useful in medicine for many implant applications. One type of these elastomers, silicone gels, are very fine as a breast implant material. Silicone gels have very little cross-linked. And usually they don't contain silicon and any other filler. Nevertheless, the consistency of silicone gels can be tuned by simply varying the chain length and the degree of cross-linking. Silicone elastomers are also used as adhesive in medical applications to seal seams and junctions, or for example in electronics to isolate or encapsulate electrical components or hold together. In summary, the main reason for the advantage of the silicone polymers over carbon-based polymer is the higher resistance to oxidation and high temperatures, given that the silicon-oxygen bond is stronger than the carbon-carbon bond, 452 kilojoules per mole versus 346 kilojoules per mole. and also the greater flexibility of silicon as a consequence of the lack of substituents on the oxygen atoms in the chain and the weather bond angle 143 degrees for SiO Si versus 109 for CCC angle.